girl, I can't lie.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I look crazy. And my hair looks like broccoli. But today's video is a highly, highly requested one. It's a how I do my box braids video. Ever since I told you guys that I do my own box braids, you guys have been like,
bitch, do a tutorial.
So here I am today doing a tutorial for all of you guys. Before I do this video, I just want to let you guys know I'm not a hair expert. I don't even know what I'm doing. Like, you guys probably shouldn't even be like watching a tutorial from me. You should probably watch the tutorial from a more experienced person, because this is only my fourth time doing this ever, and I don't want like the natural hair police to come at me and be like,
oh, you're braiding your hair wrong, or blah blah blah, you should do this or do that.
Like, everything that I do with my hair is trial and error. Please don't come at me. Thanks. Bye. If you guys are liking this video so far, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content from me. And we're gonna start this video. Where the fuck is scissors at? I don't want none of your time, no. I don't want no scraps. The scrap is gonna get no love from me. Hanging at the passenger side of my best friend's ride. Try to holler at me. I actually already parted my hair. I'm not sure if you guys can tell, but yeah. I just parted my hair and put little rubber bands in it. Parting your hair is kind of hard because you're doing it yourself. So if this is your first time, I would advise that you ask someone to part your hair for you. I feel like I should blow dry my hair so that my hair is straighter, but I really just don't feel like putting heat on it. Like, I literally big chopped yesterday, and like, I don't want to like already put heat on it, so I'm just gonna try to stretch my hair as best I can. And if you guys are wondering how I parted my hair, I basically had a mirror in front of me and a mirror behind me, and I looked at the mirror behind me and I kind of just like guessed. But before we actually start braiding in and putting in the extensions, we have to feather the hair. I fucking hate this part. It just takes forever. And usually I feather the hair before I even start braiding, so this probably is gonna take a while. The hair I'm using is x-pression hair. See that? X-pression. It's in the color too. This is the packets. I will have all the materials that I will use linked down below, so it would be easy for you to buy everything if you really want to do this. Now I'm just gonna cut up here. Shit. I'm basically just opening the packet. Then you would want to open this flap and you see this little rubber band. I put my thumb through this little thing. I just cut it off. So now you just have this long piece of hair. Then you want to hold the hair like this. See, now you have two. You're gonna set one of the pieces aside. I'm gonna put this one aside. So you wanna grip the hair about like an inch down. I don't even know if it's a fucking inch, like I don't fucking know. But you wanna grip the hair like right here, but you don't wanna grip it too tight because you want the hair to be able to pass through when you feather it, but you wanna have a nice grip so that it doesn't obviously slide off. So you grip your hair like this and you take one strand. You don't need like one strand. I would say like 10 strands or just small strands, and you just kind of just go up. Yes, it's pretty simple, pretty easy, but it just takes a long time. The hairs at the bottom are just gonna start to get a little messy. That's fine. That's exactly what you want. You don't need like one strand. I would just take a couple strands and just pull them up. Okay, so when you're done, you're gonna see that this side of the hair is pretty nice, pretty neat, and this side is all messy. That's exactly what you want. So now you're gonna move this hand and you're gonna move it to the center of the hair, and you're gonna wanna grip it really, really tight, because now you have to use a big ass paddle brush and brush the hair so that it's neat. Like, kinda like this. Brush the hair so that it's neat. So one side of your hair is pretty neat and the other is not too messy, but it is a little messy, so you're gonna wanna brush that side as well. Okay, then your hair is going to be detangled, nice, feathered, and it's gonna be ready to put on your head. I'm gonna stop the camera and I'm going to feather out all of this hair, and I'm gonna get back to you guys. Okay, I'll see you guys later. Bye. I need a featherless hair. Oh my god, my hand's gonna hurt after this. Oh my god, I'm dying. I'm dying. Someone help me. I'm back. It's actually the next day. Like, I was feathering all the hair and I got so tired. So I just like put all my stuff back and I went to sleep. But I'm here now and we're going to start this hair. First things first, I'm gonna get one of my clips and I'm going to clip all the hair like over here back so that I don't have to deal with it. Second thing I'm gonna do is spray some water on this part of my hair just so that it's like easier to manage, you know. Now I'm gonna use my little brush and I'm just gonna brush it out, brush out the ends, ultimately just brush it all out. If your hair is like straighter than mine, then I guess you don't have to like brush yours as much as mine, but I'm just brushing it so that it's like straighter and so that I have no tangles. Let me bring y'all even closer. Now I'm going to take my castor oil strengthening cream. Again, everything that I use will be linked down below. Let me shake it up. I have to shake it because it's like weird like that. Okay, so I take some in my hand and I just distribute it on my hair, throughout my hair. Make sure you get it on the edges too. I just moisturize my hair because it's gonna be in braids for a while. It needs a little moisture before it gets in there. Wow, my hair has never looked so healthy. So happy I big chopped. Okay, guys, I don't know when you're gonna watch this video, but right now I'm like really close to hitting 18K. So now I'm gonna take some Eco Styler. This is the argan oil one, and I'm just going to take a little on my finger and I'm going to put it on the root of my hair. Get as smooth as possible. So now we're just going to pull the hair and put the rubber band through the hair and tie it until you cannot do it anymore. Make sure it's tight, but don't make it too tight to the point where you have like a headache or anything. Now you're going to take one of the hair pieces that you threaded. This is the part that I forgot to show you. Once you like brush the hair out and it looks good, you're gonna wanna split it into two sections. Okay, one of the sections is one braid, and this is just one out of the two sections that I split, okay? Hopefully that makes sense, okay. Take the hair, wrap it around like this. Oh God. Okay, you see this? This is my real hair, and these are the two hairs. Now you're just gonna start braiding. Just wanna start braiding regularly. And as you braid, make sure you pull the hair even tighter, but you're gonna come across a problem, like right now. You're gonna see that your real hair isn't as long as the other parts of the hair. That's why you just have to take some, borrow some from someone else. I'm just gonna take one from another side and just continue braiding. Obviously, guys, I'm not the best braider. I don't even know why you guys even want this tutorial from me, but this is just how I braid my hair. I kind of like my braids a little messy. Guys, honestly, this part's pretty self-explanatory. You just braid the rest of the hair down. I am like the slowest braider on the face of the earth, so this usually takes me about a good like 5 minutes because this is a lot of long ass hair, so like. Okay guys, I'm gonna be doing this braid for the next one. I have this tied with a rubber band, so I'm just gonna take that rubber band out. I'm gonna spray some water on my hair just so that it's easier to brush through. I'm gonna take my brush and I'm gonna start brushing my hair. Now I'm gonna take a small amount of my castor oil, put a little bit on my finger, and I'm just going to put it on my hair and make sure that it's moisturized. I'm just going to put it all on the root of my hair just so that the edges are smooth and nice. Now we're gonna take a rubber band and we're going to tie the hair really, really tightly, but we don't wanna make it too tight to the point where you guys have like a headache or anything, because we don't want that shit. We just want it to be tight so that it looks like we have a good grip on things. And this is your hair. See, it looks really nice, really neat. Now we're going to take our hair and we're going to wrap the fake hair around the real hair. Kind of just like this. You see, this is the real hair, this is the fake hair. Real hair, fake hair. Real hair, fake hair. And make sure your hands are positioned in the same exact way I am. One of my hands is pulling on the real hair. This finger is on top of this first half, but below the second half. And you're gonna want your ring finger over it like this. And just make sure your hands are positioned like this. And from there, you're going to put the real hair under the fake hair and just start braiding. Our real hair isn't as long as the other, so we're just gonna wanna take a little from this hair. See, and now we have one strand, two strand, three strand, and now we're just going to braid as normal.
I'm just ending the braid right here. I'm just taking a little hair tie. I'm just gonna wrap it around. Bam, and we're done. Bam.
I'm not sure if I have enough storage on my SD card to show you guys like every single braid because this does take me a while. So I'm just going to show you guys as much as I can. Yeah, and hopefully my camera doesn't switch off. So enjoy.
Up to me and talking down. Can't you see I am the big man? God level life.
Young hot bodies on my line, going crazy, yeah. Young hot bodies on my line, going crazy, yeah. Young hot bodies on my line, going crazy, yeah. Young hot bodies on my line, going crazy, yeah. Everywhere I go, I swear these girlies coming too, yeah. Everywhere I go, I hope these girlies coming too, yeah.
Hey guys, I thought I might do one quick little mini tutorial on how I braid my hair one last time because I have one braid right here. So I'm gonna braid my hair with it. Make sure you spray water on it. Ooh! And comb it out so that it's straighter. If you have like a straighter hair texture, then I guess you don't really have to do this, but I have 4C hair. Now I'm going to take my little castor oil full cream thing and apply that to my hair. I'm not using too much, but like don't use too little, you know, just a generous amount. Now I'm going to put a little bit of Ecofiler, put that all around. Now I'm going to use a rubber band and tie the hair as tight as I can, but don't make it too tight because you don't want a headache. Now you're going to take your hair and take the fake hair and wrap it around your real hair. And I'm wrapping the hair around like this, and I'm going to braid towards my right side because this is going to be my part. It's going to be like my side part that I'm going to wear my hair in all the time. You kind of see the way I'm holding it, like I have my real hair right here, fake hair right here. And from here, you're just going to start braiding the hair. So when you get to this point where you have one strand of hair, your real hair, another strand of hair,
You're going to take some from your right side and also take some hair from the left and continue braiding. And that's it. Hey guys, we're back. We're in my kitchen because we have to boil water. This is the water we're boiling. I just put it on my stove. Oh my God. I'm just gonna put it on my stove, turn my stove on. Oh shit. Ooh. And see, now that water's boiling. Now we need to wait till the bubbles start coming. Then when the bubbles start coming, put it in a bowl and we dip our hair inside. Let me just get out of the bowl so I can be prepared. Okay, I'm coming with the water. I'm coming with the water. Swear to God, if I pour this shit on myself. So make sure all your hair is on two sides. Take one side and just dip your hair in. Now we're gonna take a towel and we're just going to gather all the hair. Caution, it's hot. Ew, that's so fucking hot. Ew. Wow, my hair is so hot. It could have burned me. I'm gonna do the other side.
Mom, what are you doing anyway?
I'm recording me putting my hair in water.
Why?
Because this is a tutorial.
On doing what?
My fucking hair. Okay. I don't wanna be in it. I guess you could keep your hair like this and we would be all done, but I like to put some bling on my hair. So let me get my bling, hold up. Okay guys, this is my bling. I got this from the beauty supply store. Again, everything that I use will be linked down below. I take a little thing like this, I open it. Bam. I clamp that anywhere, right here. And then we're going to squeeze. Bam, it's on. Because my braid is so big, it can only fit on like a section of the braid, which sucks, but you know, whatever. So now I'm just gonna put bling all around. Okay, that's it. You're done. You are cute. Your hair is cute. Everything about you is cute. And now you can go about your life slaying. I usually touch up the edges every 2 weeks and I take this entire thing off every month. If you guys liked this video and thought it was informative, give it a thumbs up. And if you guys have any questions about like my braiding technique or just anything about what I did, comment them down below and I'll answer them as soon as possible. We literally hit 18K like while I was literally putting these braids in. Thank you guys so much. You guys are awesome. I'm honestly so thankful to have such a supportive group of people to call friends. Thank you guys. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Girl, I can't lie. And like a you watch her back it up. She do that, that's what's up.